5 essential things to take note on your plastic parts that will potentially lead to a quality recall. Your supplier passes you 2 samples. It seems identical, except for some fine defects aesthetically, which you accepted. However, before you do that, let me share you 5 things at least you need to identify before accepting the product. Welcome to my weekly video channel. Hi, my name is Samantha, the second generation owner of Glasfil Polymer Sdn. We're a one-stop plastic injection molding solution center in Malaysia. How to tell if the part is actually a defect? This is a level 1 guideline, and there are more to come in my next video, so stay tuned. Defects number 1, silver streaks. As pretty as it might sound, silver streaks looks like silver lines, or they call it streaks, often looks a little lighter in color. There are many reasons to these streaks. One of them that we are worried is that the temperature during the injection is too high. If we done the injection in a higher range temperature, it is possible that the process degraded the plastic resin's performance, and it leads to a failure in the performance. For example, if a computer mouse casing supposed to withstand a drop from 1 meter, in such case, the silver streak may cause a crack. Defects number 2, a weld line. Weld line appears on the surface of the molded part where the molten material joined together after being split in more direction and flow. The hairline weld is due to weak material bonding, so it lowers the strength of the part. In the event of a breakage, it is very likely it will crack along the weld line. And come to the next defects, which is air traps and bubbles. Air traps and bubbles is formed in the internal of the product during the injection. During injection, the air flows together with the plastic material go into the product mold. So it actually creates air pockets in it while the product cools down. As you can see, if there is gas being released, it becomes a weld. And this makes the plastic very thin, hence easier to crack as time degrades. For this, you can actually cross-cut the material to take a look whether there is any air pockets in between the material. Sometimes, we're not able to eliminate the air trap entirely due to the mold or tool design. Hence, you may want to talk to your toolmaker to solve this issue right from the beginning. Defects number 4. Underpack. Underpack is when injection molder or manufacturer did not pack the injection process with sufficient pressure, causing the plastic to look porous in the center. One way to quickly identify this is there will be a difference in weight. Underpack will weigh lighter. Sometimes may not be able to detect that because sometimes depending on the size of the parts, you may not be able to tell 1 gram difference unless you weigh them. So do weigh the parts. The weight can tell that the material is loosely filled or compactly filled. Of course, the more compact, the better. A loose fill, or we call underpack, will cause products to underperform, especially in tensile or impact. And finally, the 5th defect is called flashing. Flashing is an excessive, usually thin material that oozes out of the part at the parting line. Injection molding involves 2 sides of the mold, which is compressed together, and the material shall fill through the center. The border of both sides of the mold is where we call a parting line. This is not only an aesthetic defect, but sometimes could lead to serious product recall because it is really, really sharp. The thin plastic flash may cause a serious cut in the skin, and if this is your product, this is a serious problem. Talk to your plastic manufacturer and ask for a solution. Or if you need help, you can always contact us for a free consultation. If you like my video, don't forget to like, click on the subscribe button, and also click on the bell for notification to get more weekly updates on manufacturing tips, design tips, and some plastic injection insider tricks for you to create excellent product that works as a solution for your customers. See you next week, and goodbye.